Let us now consider the Galerkin approximation to the problem and see what the numerics gives us. So, the Galerkin approximation to the 1D problem with piecewise linear finite element method. Now, we have seen this already, that if I take a grid, let us say this is the grid point j, this is j plus 1, this is j minus 1, j minus 2, j plus 2 and so on, then I can get a typical stencil and it would look something like this. So, I will just write down the problem again for you. It is a del u by del x minus nu del square u by del x square and equal to s on 0 to 1. So, we have seen that if I take the advection problem and if I take the diffusion problem and the source, then a typical stencil that I would get using the Galerkin's approximation would be something like this. So, the first term would give me a central difference kind of approximation. So, A times I would get u j plus 1 minus j minus 1 divided by 2h, and the second term would give me something like minus nu times u j plus 1 minus twice u j plus u j minus 1 divided by h square, and this would be 1/6 of s j plus 1 minus 4, sorry, plus 4 s j plus s j minus 1. So, this is from Galerkin. If you tried a finite difference, then you would get a very similar thing. So, the first term would be exactly the same, a u j plus 1 minus u j minus 1 by 2h. The second term would also be identical. So, you would get u j plus 1 minus u j. The last term though would be a little different, because in finite difference I would simply take the value of s at the node. So, this would be simply sj. So, for a steady state one dimensional problem such as this, the finite element, that means the Galerkin form, and the finite difference are identical, except of course the source term. So, to simplify things, what we will talk about is a uniform source. So, consider uniform or constant source. So, that means S is constant. In fact, we can even consider S to be of value 1. Okay. But if you do that, then actually this would become identical to the central difference. Okay. We are going to define something called a Peclet number. So, Peclet number is something like the Reynolds number, but it is at the level of the mesh. So, the characteristic length would be of the order of the mesh size h. So, the Peclet number is defined as a times h divided by 2 nu. okay. So it is non-dimensional, just like Reynolds number, and h here is the element length. So we are talking about a uniform mesh. So maybe I should mention it somewhere that this is a uniform mesh. And the mesh size is small h. So I can now substitute for Peclet number in the scheme, and I will also put s equal to 1. So use s equal to 1 without any loss of generality, and then I can rearrange the equation. So rearrange the stencil and I would get the following. So a by 2h times Peclet minus 1 by Peclet u j plus 1 plus 2 by Peclet u j minus Peclet plus 1 by Peclet, this is u j minus 1, and this would be equal to 1. Okay. So this is the kind of equation that I would get if I take the uniform s and put it equal to 1. And what I have done is I have rearranged the coefficients of j plus 1, j minus 1 and j, and substituted for the Peclet number. So it is just this equation rewritten in that form, and you can check it. We also would like to write down the exact solution. So exact solution to A, and this is my problem A. This I am going to call as B, which is the approximation to A. So the exact solution is given as u of x is 1 over A x minus 1 minus exponential of gamma x divided by 1 minus exponent of gamma, where gamma is this number A by nu. Okay, so the speed to the diffusivity. Okay, so now the game is set. We know what the exact solution looks like. Okay, and there is only one free parameter here. So for a given gamma, I can actually plot this solution as a function of x, and I also have this stencil, so I can write down the discrete form and then solve for them. And in fact, I can compare that how does the numerical solution compare with the exact solution. So somebody has already done that. I will just draw some pictures for you to show you what they found. So we will make some assumptions. So compare solution from Galerkin method with 10 elements. Which would mean that H is 1 by 10 here with exact solution. Okay. So this is from 0 to 1. This is x. And on the y axis, I will plot u. First, I am going to plot the Peclet number 0.25. So the exact solution I'll draw in the red line. So this is for Peclet number 0.25. So my color coding is that this line here denotes exact and the white line denotes the Galerkin with, of course, h equal to 1 by 10. So it turns out that the Galerkin method gives very similar result, almost indistinguishable. Next we go to Peclet of 0.9. So it would look something like this. So this is Peclet equal to 0.9. You can see some kind of a boundary layer is already forming. Of course, in the limit when you have a very large Peclet number, you would get a very sharp boundary layer at x equal to 1. So if you do the numerical solution, the Galerkin, then actually you get, so I am only going to trace some of the curves. So you get something like this. So you start seeing some mild oscillations. Now when the Peclet number exceeds 1, so let us talk about a Peclet number of 5. So that is the exact solution. But the numerical solution does some strange things. In fact, it gives rise to very wild oscillations. So this is the numerical solution. So we are going to make some observations here that for Peclet greater than 1, the Galerkin solution displays very large oscillations. Which are actually node to node. Okay. And this implies that the Galerkin or the central difference not suitable for advection dominated flows. So what we have seen are actually two evidences. First is I showed you that the Galerkin method is unstable for advection dominated flows. We saw that you could actually satisfy the Galerkin method by having very large oscillations in VH and still satisfy the equation. The second is the evidence from the calculations. So if you use the Galerkin method and go to Peclet numbers beyond 1, so at 0.9 you are already getting small oscillations, but if you exceed 1, then of course you are going to get node to node instabilities, and this is not going to work out. So one of the options you have is you can play with the Peclet number. So let me remind you that Peclet number is given as AH by 2 nu, and for H equal to 1 by 10, you can see Peclet number is given as 1 over 20 nu, okay, actually A by 20 nu. So one possibility is that if you want to do calculations with, so if you fix the A and you reduce, keep reducing your diffusion, then you can keep refining your mesh so that the Peclet number stays within 1. Okay? But that would become very expensive. So what we are saying is that if you are computing a flow and you want to do high Reynolds number, then you keep taking a refined mesh so that you never get advection dominated inside an element. Okay, so the mesh size keeps reducing and your cost keeps on increasing for as you increase the Reynolds number. So there will come a point when you want to do, let's say, Reynolds number a million or so, you would have a very large number of grid points and you would be spending unnecessary computational resources. So that's one way, but that's not practical. Okay. So we are going to see what are the other possibilities, what can we do to the, let's say, the central difference method, and learn from that what can be done to the Galerkin method, so that we can get rid of these oscillations and still get a reasonable solution. So the first step is the following. We already know the exact solution, okay? And can we come up with a scheme that can reproduce the exact solution? So we'll do some kind of a curve fit, okay? We'll find out what scheme can give us the exact solution and compare that to the central difference scheme that we have already written down and see what are the modifications that we need. So find the exact scheme that can replicate the solution. So let us propose So the proposal is, can we find the right values of alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3 so that we can replicate the exact solution by using this hypothetical scheme. So let me call this as equation C, and we will determine alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 such that C satisfies the exact solution, okay, at x j minus 1, x j and x j plus 1. And the way to do that would be that I actually write down what are u j minus 1, u j and u j plus 1. So I can substitute for these in my exact solution. So u j is given as 1 over a x j minus 1 minus exponent of gamma x j divided by 1 minus exponent of gamma. Okay, that's my uj. For uj minus 1, I need to substitute for xj minus 1 here. So that would be given as 1 over a xj minus h minus 1 minus exponent of gamma xj and exponent of minus twice of Peclet divided by 1 minus exponent of gamma. And likewise for u j plus 1, the value is x j plus a minus 1 minus exponent of gamma xj and then exponent of plus twice Peclet, this divided by 1 minus exponent of gamma. So these equations should satisfy the equation number C and can be used to determine alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3. Okay. Let me now give you, so can find alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. So I will give you these values and then I will write down the exact scheme for you.